The Share Him Ministry would not exist without supporters like you donating your time, money, and talents. We can provide opportunities and resources for volunteers to witness in foreign lands and in the homeland. In our behind the scenes, we're going to look at our newest preaching resource, the Sermon Synchronizer.
The Synchronizer is a totally, it is so, I love it. I mean, the way I've learned how to edit it and everything, I can pour my so much more into it. I'm actually preaching now, and before I think I was just kind of reading.
The Sermon Synchronizer makes it really easy because it's really short phrases so that I have to make it my own words. I have to personalize it. And I really think it would have been a lot harder if I was going off of paper notes, having to switch pages all the time.
The paper notes, it was a pain because, you had to turn the pages. You're trying to hold all these things in your hand while trying to talk at the same time and everything. But the Synchronizer does help a lot, even though it takes a lot of work to type everything in. It takes a couple hours, but in the end, it's all worth it.
I like using the Synchronizer because I can see the slide. I don't have a color sheeted paper. I printed it off at home with black and white ink, so I can't tell what slide I'm on. I'm just reading. So I have no way to tell if I'm on the right slide if I get off. But the Synchronizer helps me with that, so I'm not lost.
I first started out with the paper notes, but then I switched to the Synchronizer because I felt that the pulpit was too large, and so I wanted to get out and be able to move around. And I felt like since the text on the screen was larger, I could move around more.
I can look at the people, I can take my eyes off the notes a lot easier, and my mom, she's my translator, it's easier for her if she needs to discreetly look at my notes a little bit. If I say something and she doesn't understand it, and it just makes the whole process so much more smooth.
It can be very difficult to speak in front of large crowds, but if that's your concern, don't let it hold you back. If God brought peace to our young evangelists in the Dominican Republic, He'll surely do the same for you when you join one of our overseas campaigns or you share Him in your own hometown.
Baseball is the most popular sport in the Dominican Republic. In fact, next to the United States, the Dominican Republic has the highest number of baseball players in the major leagues. On their Share Him campaigns, our youth evangelist encountered a group of professional prospects who were staying in the same hotel. While their initial meeting wasn't exactly friendly, listen to the story of how God broke down the barriers.
When we first got here, we found out that here in the hotel, there was a whole group of baseball players that are staying here. They're being scouted out by the Texas Rangers and the Houston Astros. We went and watched one of their games one day, and they were fairly inappropriate with our girls when we first got here, just hooting and hollering and saying things that they shouldn't say. Nothing physical, just saying things that they shouldn't say. And the group in general got a little bit perturbed at them. And we talked to them and told them that that was inappropriate behavior. But then we started talking amongst ourselves that what better thing could happen than if they could meet Jesus while they are here. So we decided to have a meeting every day in the hotel in the same room that we do the evangelism boot camp at 4:30 every afternoon to see if any of these guys would come. First day we had it, 20 out of the 30 guys came. And we presented the topic of why is there so much suffering in this world? If God is so good, why is there so much evil in this world? They really, really listened. They seemed to really enjoy it. And every day, that group of young men, and it's been increasing, has been coming down and has listened. When we do the appeal, some of them have cried. They sing with us with the songs. The verbal things that they were doing with the girls has completely stopped. They have apologized. They've said, we are so sorry. We can tell that you're not like that, and we really, really apologize for the way we behaved before. And as a team, they have asked us to pray for them because they say they have a lot of problems and that they need Jesus.
The world of professional athletes is often about fame, wealth, and pleasure, making it difficult to find a place for God in their lives. But isn't it wonderful to see how God can transform the hearts of an entire baseball team? Our Share Him team hit an eternal home run for God's kingdom.
Amen. That's right. And they had a wonderful time sharing the gospel in the Dominican Republic. and we'd love to have you join one of our campaigns this coming year. Or if you can't go, you can help us by sponsoring a ShareHim event financially. Everything we saw today was made possible by supporters like you.
An entire campaign costs only $1,200, but any amount you can give will be a great blessing. If you feel impressed to help, please call our toll-free number at 1-866-900-0123.
Or just click on our website at sharehim.org and make an online donation. But most importantly, remember, share Him and experience God's power through witnessing. There's a
story to tell. Share Him. I'm inviting you. Yes, not your neighbor. No, you. Yeah, you can do it. I'm inviting you to be part of global evangelism, now Share Him, preaching and witnessing to what God has done for you, what He is doing in you, and what He wants to accomplish through you. Now that can be campaigns, international ones like these. It can also be campaigns at home where you live in a nearby church. We'll help you, we'll help facilitate, plan, program, give you the materials, but God is inviting you. I hope you will consider seriously accepting. Just go to our website, sharehim.org. Sign up for a campaign that's international or in the homeland. Look forward to working with you.